Hello and welcome everyone to part 30 of the Kingdom of the Franks Let's Play for Age of Charlemagne Total War Attila. We continue where we last left things off. And of course that was last Thursday. There was no upload on Saturday. As I mentioned in the previous video, I spent the weekend with my girlfriend over Valentine's Day and that whole weekend. Had some fun, it was great. I hope you guys had a good weekend if you're celebrating Valentine's, or if you weren't, you were just chilling. Whatever you were up to, just gaming. Let me know what you're up to in the comment section. Why not? And yeah, I hope you had a good time. Anyway, obviously to get the schedule back on track, I didn't want to upload Arnor and Maratha Monday because then I'd have missed out Charlemagne and Viking Conquest. So I uploaded some XCOM yesterday. If you haven't checked it out already, even if it's you're looking at it going, it's totally not my thing, Lionheart. Honestly, I promise you, you'll have a load of fun with it. I'm having a load of fun playing it, and so far the response from people that are watching the series, absolutely loving it. Plus, I'm able to customize my squad members, and I've made them all Total War YouTubers, so if you want to see a Total War YouTuber die, potentially, that's the series to watch, and in a spectacular fashion, I should add. They'll probably die horrifically. Grenade to the face or something like that, or a shotgun in their crotch. So yeah, if you haven't checked it out, do go check it out. If not, and if you have checked it out, thank you for tuning in. Anyway, this is an hour and a half long today. Obviously, it's an hour special because it's part 30, but because I missed Saturday's upload, I'm making it slightly longer. Viking Conquest upload will probably be around an hour long as well today. But yes, this, an hour and a half. There may be a couple of like quick pauses and cuts, just if I need to pee or if there's a knock at the door. I'm the only one in for the next few days. I've actually gone downstairs this morning and disconnected the phone because I was recording something earlier and it kept on getting ruined by the bloody phone, and they're all messages for my parents who aren't in. And I'm like, I really don't care. Like, they have mobiles. Call their mobile number. Ah! So, yeah, and there's no, the phone noise, like, there's no way to just mute all the handsets. So I literally just pulled the cable out the wall. For the phone, so screw anyone that wants to call the home phone over the next few days. I'm not having it. You can tell it pissed me off. So, great start to the day. Angry Lionheart, rage mode, ripped out the phone. No, I just unplugged it, it's fine. So yeah, there's no phones for the house. My phone is on mute, so no distractions. It's all good. And calm, Lionheart. Calm. Right, anyway, what really grinds your gears like that, though, when you're, like, trying to get in the zone, and the bloody phone goes, I mean, there probably will be a delivery at the door, which I can't ignore, because there's a couple of things coming, which I know are coming, and I'm excited about, that are arriving, so, yeah, anyway, there might be some pauses, I'll try and make them as, you know, as painless as possible, so, right, well, I also spent some time, before I started recording this today, finding out if there was a bug with Carloman, if I killed him, whether or not we could form a United Kingdom of the Franks and turn all that orange into our burgundy purple that we've got with Charlemagne. And it does indeed work. If we kill him, I think it takes about 5 or 6 turns for the whole event chain to trigger and draw out, because you essentially get, Carloman has died. This seems to have caused some problems in his kingdom. There'll be a mission issued in a few turns to explain this. And then, a few turns later, you get the mission going, ah, who are you supporting? The Separatists? His son? You know, you claiming all this land for himself, or are you doing nothing? Obviously, I want to claim all of his lands and unite that orange to our burgundy. So, that's what we're actually going to be doing this part. I was thinking, like, really aggressively pushing after Sicily, but I'm actually thinking I'm going to make peace with them so that I can draw these armies up toward, well, at least one of them up towards Paris. We'll probably just leave this one at Olba, Olbia rather, and we'll pull my heir, as was originally intended, back to Chartres. Because if we take Paris, all of Carloman's lands become ours, which means that even if we're at war with him and he starts taking some of my lands along the coast, they'll come back to me. All I need to make sure is that his allies, which will join him in a war when I kill him here, well, I can't kill him here, actually, because if I attack him, this is the extent of my movement range, he's going to flee all the way over to there. So, in fact, I need to spend a couple of turns force marching in front of him. So we're going to start doing that now. We're going to get some extra mercenaries as well, just so I can make sure he definitely dies. I can't afford for him not to die, but we'll fight that battle. There'll be timestamps down below, obviously, but I expect the other major timestamp for this hour and a half long video will be us attacking Paris and taking Paris. I'd like to do it father and son. That'd be cool. So yeah, I think I'm gonna pause my conquest of Sicily right now. They've got so many people attacking them.
so many wars that I'm hoping they actually get distracted and start going after them, which will mean they isolate and leave these open so I can swoop in later and claim them. So for now, I'm actually going to see if we can get that peace with them. Come here.
Be welcome.
Oh, it's low. Really? Okay. Then maybe I will have to punch one of your armies in the face. What I'm going to do then is move this army over to here, so we can go after that army there that's raiding us, and pull this army down to Olbia. Now, they could move this fleet up to us here. That's a concern as well for later. Going to be spending a lot of money on income, well, on improving, continuing to improve the economy where it needs to. Like here, we're going to save up a little bit longer because we need to upgrade that abbey. I'm not going to build that abbey just yet. We're going to go, where was it, here, and build the gallery. And then, where was it? Was it down here at Pavia? Undeveloped land, church, school. And then what I'm actually going to do is destroy the hostel, the blacksmith, and the barracks here. Because this just needs, ideally it needs a church hospital. And it will need a cathedral for that. But then I want to convert it over to be a commercial city hub. Because Genova earns us loads of money. Pavia earns us nothing. So I want to, by destroying these two buildings, I want to start building buildings that are going to earn us money. And I'd like to convert Pisa as well to another trade port. But we are going to need that hospice at max level to even... I think Pisa will always be minus two. Because it's also got the marble quarry complex. But I want to maximise the amount we can earn here because it's our highest earning province right now and I want to keep pushing that. When we do take Carloman's Kingdom, from my little test, corruption is going to be a massive issue. It went up to like 90-odd percent. It's going to be bad. It's not going to be pretty. Economy down the toilet, so I'm going to have to spend a lot of turns trying to sort it out. So if I can do most of that now, then that'd be grand. What I'm going to try and do here over the next, over this part of this hour and a half video, is to like just buff my economy as much as possible, and hopefully unify my kingdom. We'll just see if we can maybe get an advance on Sicily. If we can defeat one or two of their armies here, if they push for us, then we can probably negotiate a better peace. When we are at war with Carloman, I'll be drawing these armies that are in the south, north, because he is going to attack them until we can make peace, which I will try and do as soon as possible after killing Carloman. We will then have to make peace with his allies. We'll then redeclare war on him when we choose to claim Paris. As I said, it doesn't matter if he claims... He'll probably claim these coastal regions, Valencia, Tarragona, Barcelona, but all of them will come back to me when I claim Paris, but... it kind of helps that most of his armies are all down here in Spain. That this Spanish campaign has worked really well in my favour, especially for this moment now. Anyway, end turn. Hopefully get through quite a few end turns. I also think that very shortly, I'm going to hit the next level of Imperium, which will actually result in me gaining a short victory. I'm not ending the Let's Play there. I want to unify my kingdom. We're probably going to go for a domination victory, which is the longest victory you can get, obviously, besides carrying on that and just conquering everything. I'm going to go for a domination victory, which requires us to get to Imperium level 7 and to hold 110 settlements through our own kingdom, allies, and clients. So, we shall see. But first, it's Operation Kill Our Brother. Ooh, Brother Slayer. Need to be a King Slayer. And that's the episode of this video, unless something absolutely spectacular occurs. Kingslayer reuniting the kingdom. Something like that, I don't know. The United Kingdom of the Franks. Also, I did find out, because some of you were wondering whether the Pope missions were bugged. In my little test that I did, behind the scenes, once I consolidated my kingdom and took out Carloman, I started getting Pope missions again. So I don't know if that just timed in with the year, or whether or not that was me taking out... Carloman, but they start up again, basically. Greasing the wheels. A large bribe. Yeah, better large bribe him. Chance of having children. Okay. We destroyed that. Population surplus. In Frisia. Ah, you can... I'll upgrade that. I can't do anything for that. Lots of money. I Can't convert yet. Soon, TM. Soon, TM. We're trying to save as much money as possible for the bits that we need. How are they pulled back? Bloody curs, and they moved up with a fair few armies. I don't want to go to war with Sicily. Well, I don't want it continuing.
Speak if you must. But
I'd like to have got some money out of it.
Liking for foreign babble.
What about just a peace treaty? No, I don't really want to pay you. So, in that case, you're most likely going to attack me. So I need to draw my two armies together. Okay, in that case, what I'm going to do is pop you outside. Fortify you. Pop you guys in Olbia. Not as a navy, though. I know that's dangerous having Pep in my air. I reckon we could take him down. Challenge. If we can defeat them, then we'll be able to sue for peace, or we'll be able to just conquer Cagliari and win that way. I can't remember if I've already mentioned it or not. The Navy, some of you wanted me to get a proper one. I don't see there being any point really getting one, bar taking out their transports right now, but that's a lot of money that I'm siphoning away from trying to improve my economy that I just don't think I need to do right now. So I'd rather not do that. We've got a goldsmith here for industry, although we want commerce first. Ideally. But yes, I don't think it's worth... Go for that. I don't think it's worth worrying about a navy just yet. I guess we could go for the goldsmith anyway. That will add to squalor, though. Although we can take it here, we can take it here. Or we could get the food market. All commerce is going to be rather useful. Let's go for the goldsmith to start with. Go for the goldsmith, because we can build the other one there, actually. Yeah, of course. Of course we can! But yes, I was actually thinking about this, navies-wise. Like... They're really, I don't think you really need navies. Maybe it's just my playstyle, and feel free to correct me and share your thoughts down below, of course. But I kind of feel that it's actually quite a big mistake of Creative Assembly choosing to allow you to have, being able to move armies into the sea. Now, while it seems like a good feature, transport ships, and obviously you do need to build actual navies to be able to take them down effectively, it kind of, one of the key reasons you would build a navy, especially before, like if we go pre-Empire, especially the number of times you built navies was to transport ships, which was quite key when you wanted to skirt around borders or go for naval invasions and things like that. Now you don't need to, because you just take your army and sail off. Now sure, it means you need to build dedicated military navies to take them down if you want to, but that's, I think, very much a secondary concern. I think for most people it's transporting my troops from A to B along the sea, I need a navy for that. Oh wait, no I don't. Whereas if they got rid of the ability to instantly turn into ships with your armies, and you would need a navy, I think that would force more people to build navies. I think you could still have... you could build transport ships, like, cheap, but very low defences. Or you could build military ships, which could... Maybe they couldn't take... I mean, the thing is, you'd start working out, like, do you give capacities to ships? Like, can they only take half your stack? But then that's not going to work with generals. You can't leave some behind, because you always need a general in your army. So, I guess you wouldn't work with capacities, but I don't know. I think it might force more players to build actual navies if you still had to use them to transport units around rather than just turning into ships. I mean, I like it, but also I kind of feel that I just don't bother with navies at all. Like here, I really don't see the point in investing like maybe 1,500 gold's worth of upkeep, if not more, to try and take out a couple of enemies that are coming by sea. I can just wait to get to land where my already pre-established armies can then smack them down. And they're going to earn me very little by raiding. They can blockade ports, and I will say artillery ships, they're useful. But apart from that, you know, when I can just land my army via the port, what's the point? Those are just some thoughts I had. Right, anyway, try not to do too many pauses like that, because we want to keep moving. Alright, can we recruit any more mercenaries? No, we're going to... Force march over here, because I think he's heading over to the west. So he can move up to there next time, although he's probably force marching. Yes, he is. I just got to get far enough ahead of him, which may require me to get rid of these onagers, actually. So I can actually reach him. But if I keep getting mercenaries and loads of cav, then we'll be able to take him down. So that'll be fun. I'm bringing this guy over just for vision, basically. I'm nothing else. I don't want to assassinate him with him, because we probably won't. We'll just wound him. Right. What are we doing down here? Oh, we've got that there. We can't upgrade that until this is upgraded, so we should save money for that. Or we could go for the wealth. Your Poitiers, your bordering Reims, West Nestra, Mastra, Neustria. I can't say that. Today, it's not earning me a huge amount, so I won't bother with that for now. Do you have any upgrades there that are worthwhile? I'm kind of tempted to convert that to a trade port. Might do that. I've already got that there. We need to upgrade that again, although we can get the... No, we can't get the hospice because we need that upgraded. Sorry. Morbid. That's nearly done, which is good. And back down at Pavia. One more turn to destroy that. Starting to build some other bits. Lombardy's going to be very nice and rich. Ah, my spy. Yes, I have a spy down here. Let's send him just over the sea. And then we're going to end turn and see what... Upgrade your zeal and your cunning, mate. See what Sicily is up to. Okay, Charlemagne's up there. I'm not going to put the extra spearmen in his army until we actually need to march on Paris. The veteran army that spawns there, we're going to need two stacks to take them on. Yeah. I'm kind of like thinking whether or not do I attrition them down a little bit. I know we want a big old epic battle, but also I want to make sure that I win it. So we might attrition them for one turn so they're partially weakened and then go in against them. At times like this, I ask myself, what would Charlemagne do? We shall see. Plenty of time, plenty of time. Kill them all, he said. Kill them all. And so it was. Bavaria, venturing out of your lands for once. Where are you off to? Just going to check. We have a relationship. We have an alliance, a defensive alliance. Ah, they're coming to attack me. With their armies. Okay, 2.5 stacks. They're actually not even attacking by force, which is annoying, so they could get round me.
Europe was broken, led astray by false prophets, and torn apart by the petty whims of its myriad kings. The people were trapped under the yoke of war, injustice, and ignorance. But you deposed these tyrants. With the might of your arms, you tore down their thrones and elevated true religion, justice, and peace in their place. Now, with one voice, your people hail you as the first of Europe's true kings.
There we go. Short victory achieved. So, we're going to continue, obviously. Yeah, we're invested there. Pyrim level 6? No, Pyrim level 5, that'll be. Our next objective is to reach level 6. So we finally reached Pyrim level 5. So our objectives, we've done the short victory. We're going to go for the domination victory. We need 110 settlements. We have 95 at the moment because obviously we're allied with Carloman. But all those lands will become mine. Right, can I get peace with you, Sicily?
Be welcome.
No, still low. Okay, so I need to like attack you and force you away. Now which one of you, any of you got knight attack? You do, so that would be useful. It means I can't draw Pepin in, but it means they can't draw any of their forces in as well. He needs one more level. One more level. So yeah, we're going to knight attack this guy with all that cav, and then force them back and force them into peace, because otherwise they're going to take a Jacko with that fleet. We've got a fair bit of money, though, because obviously we completed our conditions for that last lot of victory. A legacy forged. So there's obviously lots to do. Bonus objectives, lots of buildings we need to get. And the Carolingian Renaissance is what we need to research, which is all the way over there. So that's a long, long, long way away. don't know how long that's going to take. I kind of would like to get Frankish Spearman as well at some point. Like, I'd like to research more stuff, but I can't. Not quickly, anyway. Oh, no, didn't mean to go for that. Sorry. Finish building that. I'm kind of thinking, actually, before I move on to the church hospital and the judicial power for the council hall, maybe I should get at least my spearmen upgraded. It might be a good idea. Might be a good idea. Although that one as well. Mounted spearmen replaces all them. Mounted infantry. Although, yeah, I mean, actually, that's a point. Do I want to go for art? Do I want levies? Frankish spearmen instead of levy spearmen? Or should I just go for that one, the mounted infantry? That might just be better to go for the rural barracks, mounted archers, mounted spearmen, mounted swordsmen. I might just go for that actually next, and then we'll go on towards the cathedral. But we've got lots of money now, so we can... Ooh, up here first, because that will have finished converting. Thank you. It's, ooh, wow, 4K to upgrade? You are having a bloody joke. For industrial and agriculture. Okay, we need that for the manor farm. God, these things are expensive. Then again, I can't afford. It's not like I can't afford them. So go on then. Go on then. Upgrade that abbey. Then we can build the hospice. Oh, something's moving in my blinds. It's the cat. Right, we've destroyed that, so we want the food market now. Can't get the cathedral to upgrade any of these yet. Again, kind of, I like, need more research ability. Actually, if we upgraded that, then Bologna will be happy. I'll never need to move an army there again. Verona, we could probably build a priory, and then maybe we won't need a standing army here anymore. Although military presence, oh god, it's 24, it's giving. Seriously? Oh, my, oh wait, you're kind of happy, but then there's probably still military presence. Yeah, there's 10 military presence still. Ugh. Okay, no point building the priory there. Pisa, I'm afraid there's nothing I can do sanitation-wise for quite a while. You'll have to struggle on. Ah, Olbia has been hit. Yes, of course, it's under siege, you silly numpty. We need to catch Carloman. If I go normal stance, we're not gonna get in with these onagers, I don't think. I'm going to risk it. There we go. See, there our range increases. He can still move a fair way, though. So what I need to do is one more force march over to here, and then we can strike him next turn. I reckon. Ah, cool. We can get more troops, too. Cavalry, infantry, skirmishers. There we go. We'll be able to take him down. Because he can only move to there now. I can quickly get him. If he retreats, he'll probably only retreat to about here, which I'm surely I can... Yeah, look, that's as far as I can go with force march, but I reckon normal stance I can go to there. Cool, well, we kill my brother next turn. Let's move this agent up just so I don't lose track of anyone. If I'm going to attack him next turn, I really don't want the... Well, we could leave him there because we hopefully get peace with Carloman the first time, but we'll have to go to war with him twice over the course of this to mitigate... Oh, we need to upgrade Poitiers, that's what I need to do. To mitigate all of... I have to go to war with him again to mitigate... What am I talking about? I have to go to war with him again to claim his land, claim Paris. So I don't know why I'm saying mitigate. Which is not the word I want. Just random words popping into my head. Bavaria, what are you doing? We have a military alliance, so that's fine. You're at war with the theme of Sicily, and you're going north into my lands. This is not the most comforting of things to be seeing, if I'm perfectly honest. But that's fine. For now, it's time for a battle. And it's a knight attack, so we can't control a large army. But they can't reinforce with anyone. Crap ton of cavalry and archers. Bloody hell. A light cav, spam. Levy spearmen. Is their second army just like that? Pretty much, except that one brought onagers. Wow. None of these guys can reinforce. Oh, the garrison can. Yay. Armoured, javs, and cav. I do not have enough cav to take on all theirs. I'd almost like to auto-resolve this one, to be honest. I'd almost be tempted. And then we could push out with Pepin. I'm not sure I'll do that well. And I kind of think we should go for an aggressive stance if we do it. If I was to auto-resolve this one. Yeah, you know what? I think I am. I'm going to aggressive it as well. Decisive victory. You only lost 841. Well, I would have not lost that few, I wouldn't have thought. Let's take on warriors. That's pushed them back, which means that Pepin can now strike. The thing is, which army do you want to strike? We'll probably strike this one first. Let's move you back. Things, if I attack you, it's going to draw these. Oh, they're only weakened. So now we could go with Pepin against all these guys. Commander. Oh no, they're all bloody fleeing. Okay. Okay, right. We've got this one. Well, we could auto resolve this one. I wanted to fight that big army there. That's who I really wanted to draw in. But that's worked out a lot better for us. Let's. Loads of little bits of cav. Lots of little cavalry. Let's fight this one. Just because I think we can probably do reasonably well. And then we'll go after that other army. Bring my other army out of Olbia. It's pinned now. It can't move. It can't retreat anywhere. We can get on it. And my brother can die next turn. Smashing. So far, it's all coming together rather nicely, even if my commentary seems a bit random and choosing weird words. I'm going to say it was the traumatic experience with the phones earlier today that set me off. It's not been my best day. Grinds my gears. I'm going to have all my infantry, including my spears, just big old massive front line that we just want to deploy today. And jabs behind. We're not going to... It's not going to be pretty. It's all going to be rather... Just straight on it. There we go. Because I just want them to come to me.
Reinforcements! More for us to kill!
Just come at me, bro, and take them down. Right, the reinforcements coming from behind them. That's fine, that's lovely. Well, they're just about to go into Onaga range. Levy spearmen. Marching forward. Starting to run now. Here we go. Oh, pelt them down. Oh, beautiful. Oh, cavalry splat damage. I mean, look at the guts on the gutty textures. Oh, dear God. Off fire at will. Focus on the general. Cavalry engaging them here. Oh, that one's already broken.
Enemy units have
throw some spears in. Oh, that general's not looking hot. Okay, we're going to tell these guys now stop firing. My cat is going mental. Up and down on the window. What are you doing? You can work out how to use a window. You've got thumbs. No, I lie. The window's open. You can totally fit out of that gap. It's fine. They are trying to take out our general. they're actually being relatively intelligent and actually trying to flank. But my javelins should be absolutely wrecking you. A few of them are going into the back of my armored swords, but that's fine. Back into formation. Go on, after them. After them. Oh, you just got enveloped. Nice. Oh, jabs be coming in. Jabs be coming in. No, 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 no. Just focus on these guys, actually. Just focus on the general. Oh! Sweet potato. One shot kill. Go. Right. Reform. There's a lovely little ridge over there that I'm going to go for. Boom. Javs has still got plenty of ammo. Nice. You guys over here. Beautiful. 30 men lost so far. It'll do. As far as well. So this is an army that's not yet been damaged.
The enemy should know when the odds are hopeless.
But the mighty Pepin. He marshals his armies across the plain. A loose horse runs wild, its master long dead. Cavalry at the flanks, ready. Right, so back to where we need to be. Artillery, it's going to fire again. I assume they have a general somewhere in here. That one. The Dux Guard. Turn them off fire at will. Focus on taking out that general. Fire at will. The cav round. Move up with the spears. Shield wall men. Spearmen, you can probably get that unit there of cav. Especially if I plow in with one of these. Oh yeah, Onig is doing well. Artillery, stop firing. In you go. Cavalry in there. Go after the spears. After the spears now. Oh, beautiful. You guys can all come out of wedge now. You're way too slow to stay in the wedge. They've got a really nice charge. In they go. Run them all down. Across the plain, in comes more Frankish horsemen. Beautiful. Sicilian might crushed. Right, back you come. Javs, how many men have we lost? Okay, 106. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do, laddie. Beautiful. Job done. Fast forward just to make sure we kill as many as we can. Sweep them all down. Just the last few. We might actually be able to take them all out. I think I saw anyone go over the red line so far, so just this final little unit there. Decisive victory. Smashing. 106 losses. That'll do. That'll do nice. So we're going to go after this other army, because I barely took any losses. I'll bring my other force as reinforcements. And have our big battle that we wanted. At last. So with this, we can either keep pushing against Sicily now, we don't necessarily need to look for peace, or we can still sue for peace. Let's see. Right.
Would that I were as swift as the angels.
Leave no In we go. They've got plenty of cav. They've got Onager as well. I am going to be reinforced, control the large army, fight this battle. Oh, and now it's chilly. I'm going to go close the window. The cat's gone out, so it's all good. There we we go. Ooh, we don't want fog. No, 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 no. Dry will do nicely. Let's push them into the sea. Oh, we have a hill. Oh, we could not have asked for a better position. I'm actually going to start higher up on this hill. I guess they're not going to advance to me, but this is their final battle that they can realistically fight. There is no retreat from this for them. They have to fight this or die. So I'm gonna start off up the hill. And actually, just a big old main line worked really well. Rather than having my guys on the flanks, which I normally do. And I'm just going to, just have all these guys placed together. Probably should have spears more loaded on one flank than another, but I can compensate that with by putting a larger cavalry force on that side. Which will be, seeing as all the spears are on that side. Cavalry up here, two cavalry over here. Let's begin. Nice hill advantage. I don't know if they're going to expand. Advance.
Good news! Additional forces have arrived!
Wrong word, seriously coming to my brain today. Oh, yes, they are moving. They are marching to us. Or maybe even... Oh, no, they're just reforming because my reinforcements have come in. But that's fine, actually. Because they're also going to get up on this hill. Although, I'm probably going to have to push towards them, as much as I'd love for them to come to me. Now, actually, if I was in the situation, oh, damn, the map doesn't go that far, I'd pull back right to one of these cliff points. Battlefield doesn't go that big. Okay, right, so what have we got? Spears, spears, spears. We'll grab all their infantry together. They have a crap ton of it. Pop them on my flank here. Then all their javs are going to go here. What we can do is push forward with my main force while presenting a solid flanked block here and just sweep in from the side. And I'm going to pop all the cavalry for them together. We're going to have them down on the lower left. I'm going to hit fast forward for this. United forces of Pepin and Roland. I mean, what we could do, since they have got their onagers on the flank, I could probably draw them in with some onager fire. No, we're going to have to start moving forward anyway at some point, which is a shame, because this hill setup would have been absolutely smashing. I'm going to start moving slowly forward. Which means that these guys actually can deploy like so, which is going to draw some fire. Seven. That's fine. I've got so much cav. I love having this cav actually on this kind of... on this axis point, as it were, because then we can punch on through rather nicely. We are going to go into that onager range, but that's fine. So they don't do anything. I can keep pushing forward on that flank, which they're not doing anything, but they will do now. So we need to keep moving forward with my onagers. I'm actually going to have to move into their range. So we're now under attack, but that's fine. Move up to here. We can actually thicken them up a little bit because we don't need to spread them as much. There we go. Now we got ourselves a battle.
We have sighted the enemy.
And we can also hit play now. At the same time, we can tell my onagers to stop firing. Move. There, cavalry's gone in there. Thankfully, I can throw some spears in. They've now left these guys undefended, so in comes my cavalry from the flanks. They've got just their light cav. Wedge it, guys. Wedge it. Target for you each. Plus this one. Artillery, off fire at will. Where's their general? He's way back there. I can't really hit him, so we're going to keep moving with you guys. Javs did a fair bit of damage, probably friendly firing because I can't actually control you guys this time as much as I would like.
The enemy is attacking our general.
He's fine, don't worry. can't zoom in as much as I would like either for this one. All of you guys slam in here. I'm gonna support with my spears. These guys are gonna come up here. My cavalry is now free. In it goes. In these infantry units go to swing on round now. In we go. In my cavalry goes through the gap that's created here.
Down.
Oh no, Roland! Roland has fallen! I was panicking then, thinking that was Pepin. I was like, there's no way.
The men are broken and running for their lives!
He got caught up too much. Don't know why I just wasted that there, but I just panicked. Go, Cav, go. Into their backs. It's worked. How many have we lost? It's okay. Considering the other battles have been so... kind of worked rather nicely in our favour. There we go. Enemy general's dead. As long as it's not Pepin. Oh, Roland, I am so sorry, bro. Although, by the looks of it, you don't have any... Oh, no, wait. You know Roland's actually really good because he's got the night battles. Damn. Hopefully, Pepin's going to upgrade from this. Upgrade, level up. Ah, oh, I'm so sorry, Roland. You gave your life for the Sicilian campaign. Flung yourself in there.
Godspeed good. We are moments away from victory.
Just fast forward a little bit. Okay. About 800 casualties. I'll take it. In the end. Probably a fair bit of friendly fire, actually, from my jabs, because I wasn't able to just manage them as well as I had done in that smaller battle. That'll do. The Onagers took out 100 of my men. Their cavalry, between all of them, probably took about another 150. Swords. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of friendly fire from the Javs there. Which ain't good. Ain't ideal. Sa. May have to have that Battle of Paris, I think, actually, probably next part, by the look of it. Because I had hope... Well, originally, I'd planned just a peace with Sicily. He was a... It says he's got 3 stars. They're all dead. Right through him. Pepin will avenge you, and he's leveled up, so he can now be a knight fighter, hopefully. We need to upgrade his cunning. Available generals. Eggihard, you are awful for governor. Awful for quite a lot of other stuff. Let's bring in a new general here. We could go for yet another Eggihard. Let's go for Louis. Oh, wait, no, he's a landowner. He should be a governor. Let's bring Theodebert in. Oh, sorry, those stars are the... Sorry, the... not the general's camp, stars. They're the army... Commander. What do you call it? Force details. Legacy. What's that called? The rank of the army. Okay. That's all it is. Right, we need to upgrade his cunning if we can. Where's his cunning? Damn, no more cunning. There's more cunning at legend level. Integrity. Authority. I just need it for night battles. Is there anything... Well, there might be something here that gives us cunning. I don't know, actually. No, I don't think I've seen anything give us cunning. No. Okay, so that's our only cunning bit. So we're going to have to go towards legend. I have to make Pepin legend before we can make good on that. What do we need for that? We need a tactician. And we need to start going down here. Plus, we're going to have to get all that. It's going to be a fair few turns before we can get it. So we get more zeal. Darn. Rat snacks. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. I think he'll be able to do it. He'll be able to get night battles again. Because we level up that one more. Then two from the other trait. Oh, no, he still needs another cunning. What can we get our cunning through? I just had loads of cunning. We'll go for armor. Go for ammunition's always good. Trishan when I see integrity when foreign. That's quite useful. Morale for commanded force. Recruitment cost. There probably was a cunning one then. Probably is a cunning one because there's authority bonuses. We'll go for strategist. Obviously, Roland had it. Right, Martell, Legacy of, you're going back to Olbia. We can move down towards here. We're going to need probably two armies to do so. Although, actually, after that battle, they could probably take a Jacko. God's chosen. So, after all that, it might still be worth a peace with them, with Sicily. Otherwise, that army's going to claim it. We can claim it back, but I also at the same time need to get Pepin. I need another army up here to help out for when we take on Paris. I know it's not for a few turns. Let's see if we can make peace with Sicily now that we've dealt with their armies. I would like to have taken land from it. Like, I mean, we could sail on down and take all these because there doesn't seem to be any armies here at all. All their armies are up here. But without, say, Provence going and taking out that force, I am not going to be able to get back in time. Unless, actually, maybe you guys can. Yes, you can. Okay. We can do this, then. Where can you go? You can go towards Olbia, but I can switch that army between the two, whichever one you go for. We just need to replenish up for a few turns. So I'm going to go here. Well, actually, it probably would be worth having you guys in Olbia to replenish faster. Okay, well, we'll leave them there. If I have to raise another army, I'm going to have to raise another army up here to help out Charlemagne. Our income is going down a bit. I'm hoping it's just because it's autumn. And we need to enter and wait to find out what happens with Carloman. So let's do it. I still assigned a provincial governor. Okay. Oh, well, I wanted to do it up in Jutland. We could pop this guy in, but is he any good? I can't remember if he was the bad statesman. Oh, yes, he is. Yes, he is. He's the one that's not assigned at the moment. So it's going to have to be a brand new one. We'll go for Louis, because he's a landowner. He will benefit from this, and we can now issue an edict. It's going to be... decreased immigration. I don't think we want public order. And food production. Yes, we do. Right, end the turn again. End the turn again. Okay. I'm trying to remember, was Roland a general? Was he part of my family or not? I'll go check that once we get through this end turn phase. Hoping Carloman, though, will jump into my trap. Come on, Carloman. Just don't put any of those big armies near Carloman's army. Please move Carloman. Yes, thank you. Yes, good. Right, we can kill him. We can kill him. Oh, yes, we can. So now, brother versus brother begins. The true kingdom of the Franks will emerge from this war. Be it Carloman's or Charlemagne's. Theme of Sicily, they do have a little force. They're obviously trying desperately to build up. Ah, no, they're retreating. Oh, and they had another army. Okay.
We beg for a treaty between our peoples. Some arrangement that will give us both prosperity and strength.
I'd like 700 gold, though. Then no. No, the disease is spreading. Thankfully, though, they should be fine with the older. Procrastinator. Oh, yeah, I've left you in there doing nothing for too long. Soz. What was that reduction on? One zeal, which is charge bonus. Okay. Okay. Well, next time I level you up, you can become a legend, so you'll get that zeal back. He's been busy. He's been busy. I mean, the one time. Household lost. Oh, okay. That sucks. Roland, I think he was part of my family. Eggihard deceased. Roland was deceased. Oh no, Roland. Both of your children died. Oh, that really sucks. But you did adopt Remigus. Well, Anselm should adopt someone else now. Well, he could seek a wife as well. Let's adopt. Who have we got? We could get Drogo. Rudolf. We've got, is any of these a general? Nordibert. So many of you want Nordibert brought into the family. Go on then, let's bring in Nordibert. He has been quite the character. We could bring in others to our family if we wanted to. We could start raising control. Check how much he's got. A lot. You two should have a wife. Come on. A wife, a child, rather. You've got a wife. Ida. Eggihard, let's gather support. You're busy. Let's gather support. Right. Money's okay for now. We've got that going. Ah, we can find it. We should be converting this to a trade port. But I can't. Why not? We've got a city. I assume it's just because we don't... No, we have enough money. What? I'm confused. Why won't let me build this? We already have the city. It's right there. Is it because of that? I don't know. I'm confused now. Where's that happened? Okay. Not sure why that's happened. Sure, have I missed something there? I'm pretty sure I have a city, and that should allow that to work. No? Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe it doesn't like me having the tribunal there. We've got the gallery here. Oh, we wanted to upgrade that. Don't have enough money for it. We could upgrade the farm, but I think we're all good there. So, Sicily. I am still going to need that one of these armies back, because we don't have the money to build another army, really, supporting it. I think we will go for peace with Sicily now. Let's see if Sicily are open to a peace treaty.
Speak your terms. Give words plentiful haste. Other business calls this day.
What about 2,000? No, okay. 500. About that and a trade agreement. No. Okay. That and just 1,000. Okay. That and 750. I want to get something out of this, guys. Take 300. Fine, peace treaty, go. Really? That's annoying, because I can't really push and take settlement. I mean, I could try and swim over. No, I'm going to go. I'm going to have to pay them then. I will have to give you money.
Greetings in the name of our Lord. Speak, but do not deceive with...
What?
Oh.
Okay, well, yeah, you're just not having any of it, are you? You've got that army there, which looks pretty broken. They can't now get up to a Jacko in one turn. This army's looking a lot stronger now, so I'm going to force march these guys down. Maybe we will just punish them both with two armies. Ready for further orders. We shall see. We shall see. Could strike that one outside, then we could draw them all out. That's their garrison as well. We don't have Night Fighter anymore to help me out, which was instrumental in that last one. Anyway, Carloman can be killed now. Oh no, he can still flee further. Oh, that's his... maybe not. I'm risking it. I'm risking it. Do I want to call my allies in? Not really, no.
War against you is not
They've
enough.
Had Granada. Provence and Seville have joined in. Yes, he didn't move far enough away. Thank crap. Right, now I'm going to very quickly get peace with Provence.
Come then.
What? Speak. No, I can't. Because... Okay. Who else am I at war with? Seville.
Before you say anything.
Really? Okay, fine. Go kill Carloman. Go, go, Carloman. Go, go, kill him. We're fighting this one, of course. Got to see my brother die. Obviously, we don't have the onagers, but we wouldn't have been able to make it this far if we'd kept them. We're just going to ambush him. Nordibert is the assassin tasked with taking him down. Okay. Right. We've got Javs, which we should focus on killing Cullen. We can't afford for him to escape either. So I'm going to have to mob him with cavalry. He's over there. There's two swords to deal with their spears. We've got mercenary armored swordsmen, a mercenary Andalusian infantry. And we've got this Iberian cavalry and skirmisher cavalry. I might send them all, I think, against him. And I'll keep my general here. Oh, so that's a spear. What? Oh, there's a bug there. They're showing up as a spear unit. Oh, mercenary Spanish ambushers. Oh no, wait, no, they're probably not. They are spearmen, but they look like javelin men. Okay. I could probably deploy them outside of the deployment range, couldn't I? Splendid. Splendid, splendid, splendid. Just get around him so that they can't come back to us. Let's see him. Where is he? There he is. Old Carloman. Okay, he's finally moving. Just look at his face until he decides to move. See, their archer's actually shooting at me. They've got higher range values than... Right, come on, Javs. You guys around here. Where we go? Flank and see, flank and see, flank and see.
The enemy is going for our general. Protect him.
Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Going for my general. Those archers. Let's pull him back. I'm trying to draw them to him. But it's not working. Right, we're just going to slam on into these guys. Get my cavalry behind now. Right, Jav Cav. Go for Carloman. Get you guys in. Here we go. Assume he's the one with a different shield colour. Put these guys back. Just make sure he doesn't get away. Okay. Wedge with all these guys and we're about to come in like a thunderous fury. See him. There he is. No, he's still on his horse. No, he's knocked off again. Yes.
Excellent. Beautiful. Excellent.
And now we can slay his forces.
Forward. We have gained the upper hand.
Beautiful. Carloman is dead. He falls. Love that we managed to capture that.
Victory! This is your day!
I must try and kill them all so none know what we have done. Fast forward, fast forward, fast forward. Kill them all, kill them all, kill them all. Job done. Wonderful. Wonderful, 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 wonderful. It's all good. Ah. Nice. Down they fall. And take on warriors.
We hunger for battle, Commander.
And now Carloman is dead. Have we got anything about his succession yet? No. But hopefully we will do. Nordibert has leveled up. Who's in command of the Franks now? Oh, a Pepin.
Speak your speech.
There we go. So we can get peace straight away.
Wash away today's stench.
Oh, can we arrange a marriage? I can offer my daughter to him. No, we don't do that because we're about to attack you again. I'm just going to drain as much money from you as possible, please. Oh,
peace,
that counteroffer.
Forged between men is a worthy thing. What say you?
I say that much. Thank you. Now we have peace. Now I can get peace with Provence.
The blessings of the Lord.
Oh, we are instantly at peace.
What then do your noble people desire of us?
So we're just at war. Extra war is with Seville.
Am I always?
That's fine. Right, Nordibert. First of all, let's get rid of all these mercenaries that I've recruited you. Then you need to hightail it to Bordeaux. Well done, Kingslayer. You've already got that public order bonus. Let's get those two. Start heading you down towards legend. Nice. Well, that worked smashingly. Right. Why can't I have you? Right. Over here at Pavia. We can't do anything there for a while. Oh, likewise, you can't build that. Oh, no, wait, that's fine. We've got the wrong building there anyway. I was thinking, what? Let's repair all these because they got smashed. Can't move any further with them this turn. Alright, well, we've got a little... Oh, I know where this money needs to go. 4k on that. So I can then upgrade that. What else do we want? We want the mint might as well right near. Charlemagne, we might as well throw in those spears now. Start getting you ready. Well, we can only get two of them in this turn, but we'll start you. Going for them. I'm going to either need to build another army or bring Pepin home super fast. But we'd have to move him now probably if we've got any hope of getting him back. I'm probably going to have to build up another army. Because we can make Sicily pay here. Unless that army moves further down. Oh, I don't know. I have to see what happens. Oh, I've still got my agent there chilling. Chilling around.
We must walk alone. The alliance is ended.
Whoa. Okay. You better not declare war on me. Arsehats. Or I is going to be a pissed lion. If you do. Don't mess with me. Where are you going, Wessex? Okay, political gain. And, ooh, what are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing? We are blocking a promotion. Minus 20 influence for Carmen. Appointed Marshal. I don't think I actually set you to go there, did I, Mr. Marshal? I'm going to block the promotion. Unforeseen complications. Damn. Managed to gain some control, though. There we go. Carloman's death. Your brother and fellow Frankish king, Carloman, has died. Now his kingdom is in turmoil. His wife, Gerberga, or Gerberga, has maneuvered their eldest son, Pepin, onto the throne. Although he is still a boy, those loyal to Carloman support his accession and are willing to fight for his cause. There are, however, some among his generals who seek to unite all the Franks under a single monarch. Disillusioned by what they perceive as Carloman's poor leadership, they would undoubtedly support you as the true claimant to his lands, should you wish it. However, if you prefer to seek a purely military resolution to this matter, you should expect all those who do not support you to rally to a single banner at the capital. Perhaps this will be a chance for you to deal a single decisive blow. You must decide your course of action, or you must soon decide your course of action. A dilemma will occur soon, or will soon occur. Character adopted into the fold. Boom. Quarantine. Okay, I don't know why they broke their non-aggression pact, but Carloman is now dead. In fact, Nordeberg could command the second army, seeing as we're dragging him up here. We're going to need to get out of Pamplona with these guys. As soon as we want to declare war. Because it will begin. In fact, yeah. Ready for orders. It will begin. Right, let's get Charlemagne to get another sword unit. One more turn till that industry is done. How is... They're desperately putting forward... Oh, they're pulling more armies over here. I'm going to try again with Sicily.
Greetings in the name of the state and so forth. Now, what do you...
So they really don't look like they want peace, so I'm kind of in a position where I need... I'm back to where we started. Unless I was able to send one army to destroy a couple of these regions over here. But when they start building up, we're going to be in trouble again. No, oh, that's an admiral, a proper navy. Okay. But that's a general as well. If they bring him onto land, then we're a bit screwed. I'm gonna move down here, then, with both my armies this turn, and just see if we can draw them out to us, what that achieves. If it achieves nothing, it achieves nothing. We shall see. Still don't really want to build a navy just because of the economy implications, but it looks like we're going to have to build another army because I can't get Pepin up here quickly enough. I'd give these units over. In fact, we could give the skirmishes over to Nordibert. I'll go do that because we don't need to recruit any more skirmishes then. He doesn't need it. Well, he might need a few more bits of cav. -3 at this point, even with a priory. Is it just the... I assume it's a religion still. Well, Christianity's dominant. Difficulty level and taxes and characters. Okay. Probably need a priest down here. That could build one. I could make one. Natural gift, success chance +10. Critical success. Let's just build you here. Activate your ability, that'll help. So, Colin's probably going to take most of those territories. Annoyingly, you don't get his armies as well, which would have been grand. But then... That would cost me even more money. Yeah, I'm prepared to see my economy go to the toilet. What we're doing. This is probably not the best thing to do for economic policy, but we'll find out. Yeah, anyway, the Avars, actually. They're deteriorating. They admire strong empires, though.
Anger or agreement, as you wish of them.
Military alliance? Not even that. If I arrange a marriage... I could demand your wife. No, that's not going to do anything for him. Okay, right, well, we'll ignore you. Oh, there was someone there without a trade agreement with me. Provence.
We are, as always, a welcoming host to you.
Worth a shot. Kingdom of the Franks. You don't like me at all. Lombards.
Speak your trade. Speech so that I may go. Greetings in the name of our Lord.
To be fair, there's no point doing that. So it's actually not his son. Well, historically, it is his son, Pepin, but it's taken 21 extra years. So yes, he would have been a boy at the right time. But he's now grown up. He's actually a legit ruler. We don't need any of this controversy. Let's end the turn again. Assassin must remember to move him. To remove, move him. What are you doing with Astorius? Is hello. What are you doing? Here we go. So, here are the various options that long, long, long ago we all discussed as to what we do. And obviously I want to claim his lands, which war will soon be declared between you. Taking Coloman's lands will cause his men to make a power play of their own. Support the sun. Carloman's faction will be extremely favourable towards you in the future, so we could just continue being military allies. Now on his land. Do nothing, a day of mourning has been decreed, so plus 100 public order. Staying out of Carloman's succession may seem wise, but an opportunity may be lost. Or we could bankroll the Separatists. By bankrolling the Separatists, you will acquire some of the lands they have captured thus far. I want to claim his lands. I claim ownership over my brother's lands. Disaffection. Oh no. Oh, rank 10. For the Uber Eggihard. What should we go for? You're not a governor. You're a warrior. More zeal, what will that do? Yeah, that will do more damage. And we could go for battle movement speed. I think we'll go for that. We don't need any more integrity. Integrity is... Oh no, actually, integrity's not... okay. We'll go for the zeal and that, then. You are an absolute legend, you arrogant... douche you. It seems rather arrogant. Italian separatists have been encountered. He's got irresolute, arrogant, out of favour, and he is unfortunately flaccid as well, so Haradan is not having much fun there at all. Okay, research-wise, I'm kind of like, do I go for the Frankish spearmen, or I don't think we're going to have mounted infantry, or do we go for cathedral, and then church hospital, and start towards council building? Might start needing to shape things up with our infantry. I'm going to start researching that, but let me know your thoughts in the comment section, guys, if you've got this far in the video. I know it's a long one. Well, hopefully, I'm hoping you guys are enjoying it. There we go. That's that sorted. Right, in that case, I'm just going to disband you then, Anselm. Norderbert, keep marching your forces up here. In fact, it might be more potent to actually then bring Anselm into the fold. The one I've just kicked. And bring him in and start recruiting troops. Get ready to take Paris. And then Norderbert can just give over the units. But I don't want to necessarily screw him over. Well, we could swap the generals, couldn't we, actually? Yeah, we'll just do that then. We'll get we might as well get an army recruiting units. We'll go with this Eggihard. Reinstate the legacy. Yeah, we're going to get rid of him anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Ready for battle. Call this a garrison. Right, so we are going to need some swords. There we go. That's how you do it. Get the swords. Right, what have they done? Their army's still there. They've actually moved away with their... Ooh, with their main force. Okay. Ah, oh, you're kidding me. We can't get any further than this. No. Damn, because now these guys are going to get into the port and reinforce, unless they keep pulling away. Oh, well, it's all going to be interesting to see what happens during this end turn phase then. That's interesting. Bologna, one more turn, that's done. Okay, we spent all the rest of our money, let's end the turn, see what happens. Come on, let's do it. Pa pa pa. Pum 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 pum. Oh, hello. Call to arms. Defend the Kingdom of Wessex and their allies, Kent. I thought Kent was a... Mercia's client. Enter on side of the ally, then. Screw you, Kent. Although you could now just walk over and start taking my lands in the north, which could cause me trouble. That's it, Sicily. Keep moving away. No, don't send reinforcements. Move that other big... fleet away. Ah, damn it! Okay. We lost our opportunity there. Although, hello. Carloman's succession. A loyalist army now defends Carloman's capital. Carloman's faction declares war on you. A mission will soon be issued. another mission will soon be issued. The Incensed Franks. Hang on, I've heard that name before. Under the command of Charles. Mutual alliance with Asturias broken. They've decided not to. It's just automatically dragged me in and it's broken my alliance with Asturias. Rat snacks. Oh, actually, we can probably get it back. We can probably get it right now.
The blessings of the Lord upon you.
Nope.
What then do your noble people desire of us?
Nope. Okay. Right, well, I want to go besiege you guys. As soon as possible, actually, because that'll start weakening them down. And then we can go in.
Laying siege to the settlement.
Oh, right, there's Palace Guard, which are tier 3. They've got Frankish spearmen. Armoured swords, yeah, they are veterans. And then archers, so we're going to need at least 2 to 1 to get them down. Plus they're in a settlement, so we need to start destroying their walls. I am going to go for a battering ram. We're going to get some siege towers while we wait. I'm not going to wait them down till they're nothing. But we are going to need to, well, one, move you guys up to here. Oh, in fact, we can move you guys all the way to the border, so they should. Oh, they're not going to reinforce because of the river. That sucks, but we can at least recruit some more troops in here. I want more swords because they have so many swords themselves, and obviously swords against spearmen are going to be more worthwhile here. They have no cavalry, bar their general, so not really much point in us getting a lot of cavalry. We're going to want javs. Wow, that's a lot we can recruit there. We've already got loads more javs coming. Just throw in another armoured swordsman, another jav. Nordibert, you need to leg it, mate. I'm not sure we're actually going to be there in time for us to attack. We might just have to build troops anyway. In which case, we might have to disband you, alas, chap. If you can't get there in time. So they're going to start taking our land, which means Provence is once again at war with us, which means that we might actually need to go back and defend Genova, which means we really, really could do with stopping Sicily. Stopping the war with Sicily right now. We just can't. Unless I can... Anselm, do you have cunning? You have 5 cunning. And is 5 what we need? Level 5, no, it's level 6 we need. And you've got 6 cunning in the pool. Darn. No one's got extra cunning. If we attack or draw all of these guys out plus the garrison, I don't think we can do it. And we're going to need to defend behind us with Provence. Oh, so annoying, but Sicily refuses at this point. Straight up refuses for peace.
Greetings in the name of the state.
Yes, okay, I'm just going to take it. I'm just taking that peace right now. Thank you.
My salutations and the good wishes of our people.
No, it's kind of annoying because we pushed all the way down. But we've got to worry about problems at home now. With Provence, so I'm just going to hightail it back. I think we need to get something to defend Genova. We could throw these guys in from... Verona. We hunger for battle. -8. I think better to have someone here than not, so let's do that. We are besieging them there. Where's my assassin? Because I keep forgetting about you. They're going to take Pamplona, but again, I don't know, it's an agent, but I would assume they're going to take quite a few of my settlements, but it doesn't matter because we'll claim them all back. When we take Paris. And I don't want to besiege Paris for too long, so these guys are just going to have to go in probably an army and a half. I just want to weaken their walls and build my siege equipment. Still want a nice big old epic battle here. So end turn. They won't start taking attrition until after this one. We might even start taking attrition if it's winter. We'll have to see. Hopefully Kent doesn't decide to come for us. I'm hoping that with Mercy and Wessex pushing on both of them, they're going to be very busy. Bum-ba-da-dum-dum-dee-dee-dee-dum. Ooh, belly. Shush now. Provence, yeah, they're moving towards Genova, as I thought. Sicily now pulling back, which might mean that Cagliari is slightly more exposed and easier to take later on. We'll see. It is winter. Pepin has a son called Pepin. Reward if I take it within 20 turns now. I'll take control of Carloman, of all of his territory, right? I'm going to take attrition because it's winter unless I break the siege, but if I keep sieging them for another turn, we will do a fair bit of damage to their forces. I could just replenish from here. We're going to need these guys because we're not, that other army's not going to make it in time. Some cavalry would be nice. Ah, one more turn away, so we're going to have to get some mercenaries to fill up that final gap. Mercenary armoured swordsmen, that's fine. I think that's the best bet, just full-on swords for this. Got the onagers here. Got archers, which I haven't used for frickin' ages. So yeah, income's gone to pot because I'm building so many more units. We're at war. Nordibert, I'm afraid in that case we're not going to be able to use your army, so we're just going to disband you. Because what that does mean is if I disband you now, you can be brought into this army instead of Egibert. Egihard. Can be brought in next turn. So Provence is moving towards Genova with three armies. The Blades of Mercy. The Blades of Mercy. They can strike it this next turn, so I'm going to lose Genova. But I will still be at war with Provence when I finish.
Do not waste.
So I'm going to have to go for them anyway. So what we'll do is, while they're busy doing all this, we're going to get ready to go and strike them from behind with these forces, both of them. We could try a defense in Genova with the army at Pavia. Might be able to grab a mercenary or two. We would be risking Boso. Would do some damage. We don't have javelins. I can Lombard clubman. Cool. Can't get any javs besides the raiders there. Unless I moved into that territory. No, we can't even recruit anymore. Damn. Ooh, choices. Well, we're coming up to the end of the episode, so I think we're going to wrap things up here and see what you guys recommend for Genova. But we'll be able to attack Paris next turn. So one more end turn, then we're going for it. So I expect next part on Thursday we'll be showing this battle, the battle for Paris, to unite our kingdoms. There'll only be one Kingdom of the Franks following on from this. So I hope you've enjoyed this part, guys. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Take pride and join the Legion. Check out my affiliates and sponsors, XMG, Green Man Gaming, and GTMA Racing. Apologies if some of the commentary has been all over the place with this one today. Just lots going on, keeping track of it all. But I think we are close now. Although, prepare to see my economy absolutely tank. This is probably one of the worst things I could do, economy-wise. The corruption is going to be insane. We're going to have to get rid of a fair few armies, probably, just to balance things out. And then we're going to have to spend a while rebuilding everything and repurposing a lot of settlements. Yep. Probably would be better keeping them as allies. But I want to unify. That's been the goal. So, it looks like Wessex is about to strike out Kent. So, yeah, until the next one, guys, ciao for now.